How would your party deal with rising unemployment, create jobs for Singaporeans young and old, and ultimately improve the lives of Singaporeans despite the bleak economic outlook here and around the world? You have a minute and a half. Your time starts now.
Okay, thank you very much for the question. I think there are a couple of aspects to this problem. One is that we need to make sure that Singaporeans get priority in jobs. We have a situation now where we have the PMETs, a lot of foreign PMETs working here. I think there are about 400,000 of them. And yet we have about more than 100,000 of these PMET that are out of job. Therein lies a possibility of making sure that we have to ease off and release some of this job in the shortest time possible to ease out that problem with the unemployed PMET. We believe that we need PMET, foreign PMET to complement, but we do believe that there is opportunity for us to slow it down. The other aspect is we make sure that the SME who are, which is the engine of growth, that employs 70% of our workforce, continue to become a strong engine of growth, the backbone of our economy. So they have to survive, they have to prosper, so the employment continue to be available for the younger people to come into the workforce and our existing workforce too. And for the older folks who are in the workforce today, the job training no doubt could help them, but we have to make sure they have given opportunity to move on to the new normal where business is going to change. Some of the business may not even come back at all. So we have to do a multi-pronged angle to tackle these three different areas of the problem.
Very good. Dr. Lim, you have a minute and a half as well. Your time starts now.
Thank you. So I'm going to start by pointing out that from a macro perspective, certainly, given that this is the worst pandemic that we are experiencing, perhaps, in our lifetimes, one of the biggest challenges to our economy since independence, it is critical that we do not hamper the economy in any way by doing something like raising taxes. So we understand that there are plans to roll out an increase in GST, and of course that will come after the pandemic. But if we believe, and we have been significant evidence to believe so, that if this contraction will be prolonged, then I think the idea of raising taxes at this time will be very counterproductive from a cyclical perspective. And then when it comes to jobs, the Workers' Party at least believes that it's not just sufficient to have jobs. Of course, we want jobs, but we want good jobs, jobs that will enable workers to work with dignity. And for that, we have proposed a number of proposals along those lines that we believe improve the quality of work. Well, one example is a national minimum wage. So we're proposing that. And we believe that that will lift wages in the heartland, so $1,300. And then the other is a redundancy insurance, the idea that you'll pay $4 a month and you'll get a payout of 40% of your last drawn salary for 6 months after you're rendered redundant.
Thank you very much. Dr. Chee Soon Juan, you have 1 minute and a half. Your time starts now as well.
We've got to stop this foolishness of continuing to bring in foreign workers, especially foreign PMETs, when we have more than 100,000 unemployed people in Singapore at the moment. Right. If you throw in people who just stopped looking for jobs already, you're talking essentially a lot more people here without employment. And then you talk about people who are unemployed. So when you take everything into consideration, not bringing in foreign PMETs, especially for the purposes of lowering wages, so that we can just buffer the profit margins of companies here, that's not a sustainable solution going forward. What we have proposed, over and above that retrenchment insurance scheme, where you're going to have to be able to shore up people and look after retrenched workers. Over and beyond that, what we want to do is to be able to allow some of these people who are retrenched and getting some of these retrenchment benefits for them to come together. So if, for example, you can find some other people who are similarly retrenched, let them come together, come up with a viable business plan. And if that's good, allow them to draw these payouts in one lump sum. And then together they can go out and start an enterprise, a co-op. Now that not only brings these people back into as productive members of the economy, but that you are going to encourage an entrepreneurial class and get Singapore to be a truly innovative society.
Thank you, Dr. Chee. Dr. Balakrishnan, you have 4.5 minutes to wrap up on this question, yes. And your time starts now.
Thank you, Jamie. This is the greatest crisis of our lifetime. It's not just a health pandemic globally, but it's in fact a deeper depression than even the 1930s. So this is real, this is a crisis, and this is the crisis of our lifetime. The central focus of our campaign is jobs, jobs, jobs. And let me focus on this point. In order to save the jobs of Singaporeans in the immediate term, we launched the job support scheme. And if you think about it, during the circuit breaker, in effect, the government was paying 3/4 of the median wage of Singaporeans. And I emphasize this, Singaporeans. If you look at the bulk of the almost 100 billion in the successive budgets that were announced, most of that is really focused on keeping our companies afloat. Why? Because we need to keep job opportunities available for Singaporeans, our own people. If you think about it, that's why our local unemployment rate, it has gone up. It went up from 3.2% to 3.3%, an increase of 0.1%. It would have been far worse if we didn't have these emergency measures in place. And then that addresses employees. We have more than 100,000 self-employed people, and they have also been facing revenue cuts. And that's why we had, for the first time, SIRS, an income relief scheme for the self-employed. Again, to provide them with immediate relief. And for retrenched workers, we have had schemes like the COVID-19 temporary support grants, and all that, again, to help them through this period. Now, that's emergency measures, but we need to look beyond. And if you think about it, the only way is productivity, skills upgrading, and seizing jobs of the future. And that's why we launched the SG United Jobs and Skills Package. And we formed a National Jobs Council led by SM Tharman. And if you've read his announcements, it's all about creating job opportunities. What does that mean? It means jobs, it means training, it means attachments. And let me be a bit more specific and deal with the different segments which you have brought up. First, a young graduate entering into the bleakest, economic contraction in his lifetime. We would say, if you can get a job now, take it. If you can't get a job, continue training. In fact, if you are prepared to take on an attachment with a company, the government will provide 80% of that allowance. You get job experience. The company gets a fully qualified young person at a fraction of what he would cost. The point is to keep them in the workforce, to keep opportunities going. Then what about the middle-aged people in my generation, from 40 to 60? And the key thing here is upgrading, skills upgrading. And that's why you see all the focus on SG United skills program, expanding training capacity, subsidizing courses by 90%, providing training allowances for people who want to switch careers into the jobs of the future, and then providing an incentive for employers to take them on. You see that, again, the point is finding those opportunities and facilitating that. We also have looked at senior workers. As so long as they want to work, and we've got incentives like the senior employment credit to encourage companies, please take them on. These are experienced Singaporeans who can make a difference. And we want to encourage them to get into the job market. So all in all, the point is emergency treatment and looking beyond the horizon. And that's what we've been focused on. Jobs, jobs, jobs.